Welcome back, guys. So this episode, we're going to see if we can perfect the art of making railroad spike bottle openers. I got a box of 75 railroad spikes on a hot forge, so let's get started. We got the first two seasoning, and I threw two more in the, oh my word, yeah, threw two more in the fire, and we'll get starting on those two. Those two off to cool. Now it's on to the next two. So we got this batch of four cooking, seasoning. I'm gonna go whip up some real food, and then we can continue. All right, six down, four to go. That was the fastest I've ever gotten any of them around. I'm just gonna quit now. So because I've done this six times before, I consider myself an expert. So this time I'm gonna use the punch plate as a spacer first, see? Well, it didn't take us too long to film this, really. Aha! Okay, because I've done six of these so far and I'm sick of punching through three times. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use the punch plate as a spacer for the first punch. That way the plug will be on the bottom, as you're seeing it now, of the hole. Then I can flip it over and punch the plug out through the Pritchell hole, and that way I'll only need to be pushing the plug two directions instead of three. If that made any sense. This wrought iron drip, but it's been working for, what is it, 8 bottle openers now, so yeah, don't underestimate iron. So as the mathematicians in the audience may have already figured out, there are no longer 10 bottle openers here. And the reason for that is I've already sold one. So if there's one thing I've learned about this craft, it's that repeating the same project over and over will definitely teach you a lot of things. You won't just become more efficient at making this one project, but the techniques you learn will transfer over to other projects and you get a better sense of how the steel moves. The first few I made took significantly longer than the last two. The last two I flew through. And once you're, you know, efficient enough, you can start producing them for sale even. Buy some propane with the proceeds. Speaking of which, if you're interested in a fine bottle opener, check out LeShaneSteel.com. Alrighty everybody, thank you so much for watching. Hope you don't mind two Railroad Spike bottle opener videos in a row. I'm starting to produce different items for the website that I just shamelessly plugged. Nevertheless, I hope you enjoyed the video. Stay tuned and make sure to subscribe if you haven't. I got more on the way. I'll see you next time.